Hey guys, a long time no see.
Obviously,
we've chatted so many times via Telegram and finally get a chance to do a video call for once. Really excited today to be able to have both Zhang and Tu from Aura Network. And you know, we have been really excited about Aura because this is our first public chain that we are launching on Impossible's Launchpad. Again, if you haven't started staking for the Impossible Launchpad, you always can check out app.impossible.finance to get started in staking. We definitely wouldn't want you to miss out on being able to earn some allocation in Aura Network. So without further ado, I think we'll love to jump straight into some of the questions that we have prepared for the team today. You know, I think obviously building a chain and an entire ecosystem is not a small challenge. And so I would love to hear from both of you guys a little bit more on kind of the vision and the goals that you want to see in the future of Aura.
Oh yeah, thank you, Kevin. Yeah, first of all, I think that we are so happy to be here and working it Impossible for us launching in Impossible Finance. Yeah, so we are, firstly, I want to introduce us. Aura is a layer one chain. So for our visions and the goal of Aura Network, first of all, we hope that we will be one of the biggest player for public chain supporting NFT for, yeah, for blockchain. And also we think that we can bring the NFT for the mass adoption of users. So it means that our visions is the 7 billion users in the world will be the users of our network. Yeah. So to doing like this, we hope that we will create our network will be one of the most good user experience for users when using our network. And we remove the barrier for all traditional users when using blockchains, like installing wallet, like plug and play, like doing swap and decentralization or something like this, very smoothly on our network. And we hope that we are creating an ecosystem to very open for any users and any builder can building the application and also the GameFi, SocialFi, and DeFi network on top of our network. So our network is currently based on very good technologies. Cosmos SDK. Yeah, so with Cosmos, we think that we will still creating a very good chain with a good transaction performance, highly TPS, easy to use, easy to build with some of our utility like Playground, and more secure with Aura Safe. Yeah.
Yes, you thanks. for some of you that follow me on Twitter, I think some of you may have seen already my tweets about some of Aura Safe and some of the security things that you guys have already been starting to do to make sure that you know, the user experience in the Aura ecosystem is as safe as possible. I think this is a great kind of tie over to the next question that we had, which was why you guys wanted to kind of focus on building on top of Cosmos. You know, obviously, I think, yeah, just a few days ago, DYDX announced that they will be also building their own Cosmos chain. So it seems like you guys are maybe ahead of this a little bit and have already started to think about how to serve more users around the world. And obviously, we do believe that NFTs are one of the easiest things for the world to kind of access and understand. So it's very powerful for us to see you guys choose the same technology that people are seeing, you know, power many of the most popular trading platforms in DeFi.
Yeah, thank you, Kevin, for supporting the expanding and summarize. Yeah.
Yeah, I guess with Cosmos in particular, are there any particular features that you guys like a lot about the user flow? That you guys are able to do thanks to the technology from the Cosmos SDK?
All right, so I think just to share a fun fact first, maybe you guys don't know that BNB or some other chains, some are very famous chains is built on top of Cosmos. So yeah, I think that Cosmos is very good for building a layer one chain. That is the first thing. And the second thing is when building Aura, we aim that we will be a very good blockchain to support every every blockchain can do cross-chain NFT, and also we connect every blockchain to us. So I think that's one of the very good in Cosmos is IBC protocol to connect multi-chain, and also where we can leverage something like ICS 721, and yeah, and we leverage sometimes something like the technology from the Wormhole SDK, and also another tie to create a blockchain, and also the cross chain for NFT and also asset management.
I see. Yeah, you touched on a lot of very important things. This bridging and the ability to bring these assets from other chains. You know, obviously there's many kind of blockchains out there, and you know, we should not assume that every user will only use assets from one ecosystem. But if you guys are already kind of from day one compatible with many other chains and ecosystems, that can only help in allowing more users to be able to easily access your ecosystem. So I really like this approach.
Mm-hmm. And I think the thing is maybe about the Tendermint. Also, I think Tendermint is so good to support the users can building and easy to scale with our network and also the Cosmos. I think that is the second thing with big Cosmos.
I think most users probably will never do much research into the consensus mechanisms or any of these things, but it is definitely good to know that Tendermint powers, you know, many blockchains now that are worth billions of dollars today. I think on our public sale currently, our network will be at a fully diluted value of $65 million, which would put it at only the 23rd or 24th highest market cap of any Cosmos-based blockchain. So we fundamentally do believe that you guys are doing some very cool things and can be a very valid option within the Cosmos ecosystem. So I think now that we've kind of dived a bit into the numbers, maybe we can chat a little bit more about the tokenomics and some of the more details on the Aura token. We're super excited, obviously, to host your guys' public sale, but maybe you guys can share a bit more on some highlights of some of the cool things that you have in your tokenomics.
Sure. Oh, okay. I think, before talking about the token metrics, we want to share that. We will launch our token by the BSCs first. So the first is our token with the BSC token, but after we release our mainnet, we will swap into Aura coin, so the native coin of Aura blockchain. So after maybe Aura release the mainnet, say it's a little bit things we need to do to swap the Aura token currently to Aura coin. About the token metrics, currently we had already announced that we almost from close for the seeds and the private sales. So we already raising 14% for fundraising at the moment. And with reserve for the ecosystem growth is 20% for the airdrop, for to support for community and for the builder. And we save for 7% for the future investment for something like the incubation for Aura or something very, very good for a future technology, maybe for metaverse or something like this. And as I already said to you that we will do the public distribution, and currently we launch with Impossible Finance, but we will do some initial listing, not only at Impossible Finance, but also we do it on some other centralized chain. There's some our partner like KuCoin, MXC, Gate, And we also using the foundation reserves to building the foundation for the Aura foundation. And this is around 10%. And the block reward currently we set it 25%. And finally, the team and advisors, currently we do is 20% and looking for 1 year for all team. And another good things when users using Aura, when the token still low, the users still can do staking with Aura. So I think that is one of the advantage point for Aura token currently,
Gotcha. I think thanks for sharing us and walking through all of these tokenomics. So as our users already know, the Aura token will start as a token that is tradable on BSC. But that once the mainnet is ready, there will be a migration, and that we will be able to share more details about all the bridging and how to be able to get all these assets over to the mainnet Aura chain. I think this is something where obviously the market has not been super great lately. And I think that this reminds me a lot, to be honest, of 2018 when I had the chance to be able to launch a lot of new awesome blockchains like Matic and Harmony, Elrond, Stellar, so on and so forth, back at Binance Launchpad. And I saw a lot of teams kind of thinking about ways to be able to prepare kind of through the bear market conditions to be able to bring up a lot more long-term usage and ecosystem in the token beyond just the token, but that actually for the entire chain ecosystem and the projects that are building on top. So maybe you guys can share a bit more of some of the quote-unquote bear market strategy that you guys have been preparing to continue to find more ways to kind of stand out during these market conditions.
Okay, I will answer this. At Aura, we are really confident with our talent resources, and our team focus right now on the product quality. So we allocate our resources for the product development and refinement. So we believe that in this bear market, Aura can shine totally, because besides the builders and the crypto native community, what we most important goal is to drive the users from the general market, and the users which are the current users of brands and other business to the industry and of NFT. So by optimizing the NFT use cases and utilities. So right now we think that the market and community is focusing on building instead of, you know, in the bull market, everybody is just looking for a green candle. And we're always currently welcoming new projects and builders to Aura so that we can provide the best support for them.
Yeah, I love it. I think it's definitely not easy to avoid kind of the people that hope to just see the green candle. But I think you guys have been doing a lot of great things to start seeing even more organic building within your ecosystem. I think this ties a bit to the next final question that we have today, which is about how you guys have always had this kind of user-focused approach to reducing these barriers of entry for the quote-unquote real world. What do you think users can expect to see next from you guys? What any big kind of announcements or updates that you guys wanted to share?
So we already released two testnets. One is the Serenity and one is the Halo for the validators. So we usually joke that Halo is like a bit Hogwarts, so everybody can, the validators can come and try. But the next milestone is that we are going to launch the Euphoria staging network, and it is stable and it is closest to the mainnet version. So we want to work with the most reputable validators to secure this network. Actually, we just announced our official validators invitation recently. Before the mainnet, we will go public listing on not just Impossible Finance, but also a SEX also. So that is the important milestones, the upcoming ones that we have right now.
Awesome. Yeah, I can't wait. I definitely want to spin up a validator myself too. So we'll definitely chat more on that. And if there are any other Impossible teammates or ecosystem participants that want to dive deeper into the tech, I'm sure we'll be able to share some more tech details as well coming soon. So yeah, really appreciate all of you guys kind of joining in today for this interview. I think this is, I think, our first time, maybe the first time. I think some fans will remember how many teams have had two teammates show up for the interview. But I think you guys have given some very thorough answers on both the product side, the strategy, as well as the kind of future that we see for Aura. And so we're really excited to be able to launch Aura. So as a friendly reminder for all users again, you can get your allocation by staking at app.impossible.finance/explore. Aura is, I believe, the pinned top project to be able to tap into. And we'd love to see more people get ready to stake and participate in the Aura token sale. So yeah, thanks everyone for joining us today, and really appreciate your guys' time. Cheers.
Yes. Thanks. Thank you. Bye. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye. Yeah. Bye-bye, everyone.